Hey everybody, what is good? Jacob back here with you in another alley in my car, waiting to do a session. And I thought this would be a great opportunity to do another session of Mailbag. Got a lot of great questions on our new forum and in email form about a whole bunch of stuff related to IRs, NAM, all kinds of things. So I'm gonna do my best to answer two or three of them right now. Okay, so the first question comes from Adam. What's going on, man? Fellow cellist and frequent contributor. And he's asking about which pickup systems for cello might be most effective with the Tonedexter. So in previous Tonedexter tutorial videos, I talked about the need to have a really full range pickup system and how duller pickups like the Realist, and I don't say dull in a negative way, it's just that you don't really get a lot of high frequencies coming off that pickup. It's just a fact of physics, although some of us like that sound. Don't perform as well with the Tonedexter's system. And because the Tonedexter is trying to match everything it's hearing from the mic, it can sometimes spike and add a lot of highs and even sometimes hiss to maps it's making with a Realist pickup. So a couple of recommendations. I would check out bridge-based pickup systems tend to do very well. In other words, systems that are implanted into the bridge. So Eric Aceto's system, which is one of my all-time favorite pickups anyway, and that I use all the time, is a great choice, but a pricey one. You could also check out Fishman's C200. That's not the 100, the little wing slit that a lot of us know, but it's the one that's actually embedded in the bridge. And then I also really like the Shadow Nanoflex system. And all of those can be heard on the pickuptest.com if you want to just hear how those raw pickups sound. But as you're listening again, check out the fact that they are definitely much brighter and more full frequency than the Realist. Have a listen for yourself, compare, and you know, if you're really looking to buy this as a platform for the Tonedexter, those are all really, really great ways to go. And when you go on to the site and listen for yourself, you'll hear why. You'll hear what I'm talking about. Okay, I hope that helps. Next question is from Matthias or Matthias, probably Matthias. sorry if I just butchered your name, dude. And he was asking if we had seen the new Neural DSP mega uber flagship effects processor that's coming out at NAMM, or that came out at NAMM, and what my thoughts were. So this is kind of a general, broad question, and a lot of you guys might not particularly be in the market for a new $1,800 super mega tricked out effects processor. I know I'm not right now, but a company called Neural DSP, who does make amazing plugins, I'd highly recommend you check out some of their plugins, particularly if you're into hard rock and metal on strings. They're Pliny plugin is totally incredible, very reasonably priced. But this small European company has decided to dive into hardware and produce this unbelievably powerful, in terms of the specs, I think it has like four Shark chips in it, mega processor to compete with, you know, Fractal and Kemper and I think mostly the Fractal stuff, where, you know, there are these classes of effects processors that are usually rack-based that just have so many options and so many things they can do. you could just spend the rest of your life tweaking, and then you'd never learn any licks or how to play in tune. But it's out there. So the short answer for me for this, because again, I don't know how many of you guys would be interested in purchasing something like that, is that I don't necessarily think it's any kind of a game changer. The company really specializes in super high gain effects anyway. They don't have any track record creating hardware. They don't have any track record creating other types of tones, outside of, you know, modeling really great high gain amplifiers. And they do that well, but, you know, if you're not a metal string player, I'm not sure how big of a deal this new processor is. You know, will it be easier to use than a Helix? Will it be more practical than, you know, Boss stuff or, you know, the pedals most of us use? All of that kind of remains to be seen. You know, it kind of reminds me of the new MacBook, or not MacBook, the new Mac Pro that came out that can be upgraded to, you know, basically a supercomputer, and you can spend $100,000 on it. Who really needs all that processing power? And whose creativity is really being constrained by that instead of by other things, kind of remains to be seen. But it's interesting. If someone wants to send me one for free, I'll definitely plug in and check it out. Next, we have a question about the IR libraries, the cello IR libraries. I've had a couple of people, so I'm not going to name everyone, ask when they're coming out, why they're not out yet. Obviously, they were supposed to be out a long time ago. And the reason is pretty simple. We had some issues on our first day of testing with, let's just call them technical issues. And then we had to retest. And then we redid the entire thing with the cello pickups. That's, you know, me booking out a studio and the time and, you know, going in and doing it. And we got results that were pretty good, but I didn't think they were good enough for the cellos. And so I've been talking to James at Tonedexter about it, thinking about using different pickup systems than I did the first time, so that we could get better target maps. Long story short, I haven't been delaying. I really want this library for myself. And the amount of time and money it takes to go in and retest is kind of a big deal. So the only reason it's taken this long is because I want it to be amazing. I want it to sound as amazing as the violin library sounds, which is freaking amazing. And I don't want to put anything out to you guys that I'm not putting my name behind, or the name of the pickup test or electric string player behind, that isn't completely great. So to answer your question, we are going to try again on February the 25th and the 26th, when we're doing all of our pickup pickup testing. Got some really exciting pickups and mics to test for you guys. And at that time, I think we're going to get really, really good stuff. It's been an iterative process. I'm going to send that back to James, and then definitely in March. And I say definitely, I don't like using that word, but I'm going to use it. Definitely in March, we should have that library ready for you guys. So thanks for waiting. I know it sucks, but it's going to be worth it. Okay, well, that's three questions. I think that's good for now. If you like these videos, if they're helpful to you, even though I know they're not the most high production quality sitting here in my car, please leave a comment and let us know, so that I can stay interested in doing these. Okay, everyone, talk to you soon.